أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم شرع لكم من الدين ما وصى به نوح والذي أوحينا إليك وما وصينا به إبراهيم وموسى وعيسى أن أقيموا الدين ولا تتفرقوا فيه. My respected brothers and my sisters, today I'm going to remind myself and everybody of purpose of life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a task as a human being. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us goal to achieve. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us with purpose, with mission, for a reason. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ We have not created you for any other reason but to stay, to live this life as a abd, as a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before I will go in tafsir of the ayah of Surah Shura I have read in front of you, I want to remind myself and you, brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made humans ashraful makhlukat. He has created us ahsane taqweem, the best of the creation. Allah has given us faculties that He has not given to His any other creation. He has given us aqal, mind. He has given us ability to talk, to communicate, to plan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this capacity to choose between right or wrong. Allah has given us capacities, bounties, faculties, resource that He has not given to any of His other creations. There is a reason for it. There got to be a reason for it. Today, I'm going to share with you what Ibn Qayyim Rahmatullah Alayh has said. You know, angels are created with purpose but no desire. Animals are created with desires but no purpose. But you and me, Allah has created us and He has given us both choices, desires and purpose. The purpose of our life is what Iqbal has said, Ya wus'at-e aflaq mein takbeer-e musalsal, Ya khaak ke aahosh mein tasbih-o manajat, وہ مذہب مردان خدا گاہ خدا مست یہ مذہب ملا و جمادات و نباتات. Iqbal says there are two categories of Muslims. One category of Muslim is that they are always busy in making sure they keep the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala high. They are always engaged in making sure they deliver what they promise when they have said kalma la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. They understand that we are here for a mission, for a purpose, that we have to understand this deen ourselves and then apply this deen on ourselves, our family, and to invite all humanity towards the blessings of this deen. So they do what they say. They have said kalma la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, so they will deliver their promise. And they are busy day and night to deliver the promise. And there is a second category of Muslims, and they are busy in khanqa, in mosque, at home, in tasbih manajat. Ya khaak ke aahosh mein tasbih manajat. The first category, that they are busy in making sure to keep the word of Allah high, to deliver what they have promised when they say kalma. These are the people about whom Iqbal says, these are the people, wo mazhabe mardane khudagah khuda mast. These are the people that they have identified the purpose of life. And the mission of their life is to seek the pleasure and love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is their priority and they know why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created them. So they know the purpose of life, the mission of life. The second category of Muslims about whom he was saying, Ya khak ke aghosh mein tasbih o manajat, they are busy just praying, tasbih, manajat. Ye mazhab mullao jamadat o nabatat. These are the people. Mullah in Iqbal's vocabulary is not ulama. He calls mullah to a person who has a limited vision of Islam. People who think Islam is just the name of Salah, Som, Zakat and Hajj. Iqbal calls that tunnel vision, that narrow-mindedness. He refers mullah to that mindset. So Iqbal says, these mountains and trees, they also do tasbih of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If human being who has a limited vision of Islam, limited understanding of Islam, and he also does the tasbih of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, manajat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then what is the difference between mountains, trees, and human being, which is ashraful makhlukat, who is created on ahsan taqweem? Then what is the difference? The difference is the job of a Muslim is ya wus'at aflaq mein takbir musalsal, that they are busy in propagating the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, applying this deen on themselves. This is the mission of their life, my brothers and my sisters. Iqbal in Satan's Majlis Shura also explains this concept. Mast rakho zikro fikr subha gahi mein ise, pukhta tar kar do mizaj khan gahi mein ise, hai yahi behtar ilahiyat mein uljha rahe, ye kitab ullah ki taweelat mein uljha rahe. Tab mashriq ke liye mauzu yahi afyun thi, warna qawwali se kuch kam tar nahi ilmul kalam. Iqbal says, you know, Satan is instructing his agents that make sure that Muslims, they stay away from the purpose of their life. Keep them engaged and busy in salah, in tasbih, in manajat, in interpretation of the ayahs of Quran, in appreciation of the words of Quran. Just let them stay busy in that. So they did not go to their purpose of life. The purpose of life, which I already said, is to understand this deen and apply this deen on yourself, on your family, on extended family, and then reach out to the people, to reach out to humanity at large, my brothers and my sisters. This was the purpose of life. And then Iqbal also says, Parwana ek patanga, jugnu bhi ek patanga, wo roshni ka talib, ye roshni saraba. Light bird. In Iqbal, every Muslim should be like a light bird. That wherever the light bird will be, it will shine all the surroundings around it. And according to Iqbal, parwaz hai dono ki isi ek fiza mein, kargis ka jahan aur hai shahi ka jahan aur. Iqbal wants every Muslim to be like an eagle. Like an eagle that flies high and always has its focus in front of it, has its own khudi, understand who really I am. So the qualities of eagle, every Muslim should have qualities of eagle. Sajdon se tere kya hua sadiyan guzar gayin, duniya teri badal de wo sajda talash kar. तेरे दरिया में तूफ़ान क्यों नहीं है, खुदी तेरी मुसलमान क्यों नहीं है, खुदा तुझे किसी तूफ़ान से आशना कर दे कि तेरे बहर की मौजों में इस्तराब नहीं. My respected brothers and my sisters, if I conclude what Iqbal has said in his poetry, that he wants us to recognize, to acknowledge that who really we are, what is the purpose of our life, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made us ashraful makhlukat, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us as ahsan taqweem, the best of the creation, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us all these faculties and these qualities and these attributes and this capacity, what is the reason of that? Iqbal says the reason is that we are the pupil of mission, we are the pupil have purpose in life. As Ibn Qayyim has said, I mentioned it earlier, if we have more of purpose of life in our life, we will be more angelic. But if we are more connected with the desires of this dunya, we will be more like animals, bahimi. We will go down towards earth, because animal-like qualities, they come from earth. And angel-like qualities, it raises us up, because it comes from the nur, the ruh, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the sky. My brothers and my sisters, so the purpose will raise us and the desires will bring us down. There should be a balance between the two. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives us tawfiq that we can understand the purpose of life. The ayah I read in front of you from Surah Shura in the beginning, that ayah reflects that Allah has given this mission to mission of Nuh alayhi salam, mission of Ibrahim, mission of Musa, mission of Isa alayhi salam, all prophets and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ لَسْتُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ حَتَّى تُقِيمُ التَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلَ وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. Tell these people of book that you are nothing, not even zero. Zero is a number. You are not even zero if you do not apply this book, Torah, Injil we have given you in your life, and this book, Quran we have given you. You are nothing. My brothers and my sisters, so the purpose of life is not just a career, is not just, you know, accumulating all the wealth of this world. There is nothing wrong in career, there is nothing wrong to live a good life, but this is not a goal. Goal is to stay in this dunya according to the teachings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these are the teachings, that we live this life according to the teachings of Quran. And we apply this book on ourselves, and we apply on our family and extended family, and we reach out to humanity. Wallahi, humanity today is at loss. They are basic, they have no direction. How much oppression we see in the world today, maybe the world has never seen before. Even today, there are live girls getting buried. Live girls. This is not just 1400 years ago. Go India. Hundreds and thousands of girls are getting killed because of abortion. And the only issue is they are girls. This is the only sin. When ultrasound is done and they diagnose a girl, hundreds and thousands of girls are getting killed because of abortion, just because they are girls. So many people, they don't even have basics of life. And on the other end, we have people, they have everything possible. My brother, this discrimination, injustice in this world, every soul departs from this dunya because of injustice. That soul calls upon the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where they are. These are supposed to be people of justice. These are the people who should raise their flag for justice for every creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers, so we have to learn our deen. You know, time is flying and it's like ice melting. So we have to take care of our life, you know, according to the teachings of Quran and our religion, so that we can fulfill the purpose of our life. So when we go from this dunya, we will have this kalma, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, on our tongue. Let me explain to you, brothers. If we want kalma la ilaha illallah on our tongue when we depart from this dunya, we have to live our life according to this kalma. This will not happen, my brothers and my sister, that if I am away from this kalma all my life, I transgress all the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I ignore, I deny, you know, all the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all my life, and I expect that kalma will be on my tongue when I will depart from this dunya. My brothers, we have to live our life according to the kalma, la ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives you and me tawfiq, that we can live life with a mission, with purpose. And wallahi, people who live life with mission and purpose, these are the people, they live happy life. They leave legacy behind. Nobody will remember, you know, if you have left billions of dollars. There was no rich man more than Qarun. But nobody wants to give their kids name Qarun, because nobody acknowledges this name with good memories. No legacy of Qarun. So the money, status or position you have will not leave any legacy until and unless we have purpose, and the purpose is the welfare of humanity. That's why Muhammad Ali Qalay, one time he said that if purpose of your life is achievements for yourself, then you fail. So the life has more meaning than just the career or the collection of the wealth of this dunya. So if we want to leave our legacy should be that we have done something for humanity. We have done something for other people. We have delivered this message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to other people. And we have knocked the heart of every soul to understand what is the purpose of life. Brothers, if we have lived life according to that, then we will depart from this dunya with sukoon, tranquility, with peace. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be happy with us. And when we will meet our Rabb, He will say to us, Ya ayyatuhan nafsul mutma'inna irji'i ila rabbika radiyatan mardiya fadkhuli fi ibadi wadkhuli jannati. So we will be happy and pleased, and Allah will command us to go in Jannah because you have fulfilled your promise. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gives you and me tawfiq, that we live this life with mission, with purpose, and we try our best to fulfill that mission and purpose so that we will be successful in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. Wa akhru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allah.